So in the next part of this lesson, we're going to talk about symbols. Symbols are ways to gather drawing information into a library where you can use them again and again and again without having to redraw them each time. So it makes use of pieces of art to make yourself efficient. And, you know, if you have one tree, well, then you could have a forest, right, with just one drawing. So we're going to show you how to do that today with your character so that when you use parts again and again and again, you know, you don't need to redraw it 1,500 times. Maybe you just need to redraw it 5 times and then you're good. So let's take a look here. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to shrink down everything to fit our stage. And I'm going to hit Command A to select everything. You can see they're selected. And then I'm going to go to the Free Transform and I'm going to scale everything down holding Shift so that it doesn't distort. Okay. Now I'm going to move it up so it fits nicely. That's about the size he'd be in screen, maybe a little bigger. That looks like a pretty good size to me. So with each layer, I'm going to lock everything, and then I can say, let's start with the backpack. You know, the backpack might not move, but we're going to make it its own symbol anyway. So I can hit Command A again, selecting all on the backpack layer, and you see that the backpack is selected there. So I want to go to Modify, Convert to Symbol. And you'll see that the shortcut for that is F8, and you may have to hold down the FN button. Give your symbols names. You're going to have a lot of them. Keep yourself organized. So with the name, we just call it, we'll call it MB for Monkey Boy, so that all the characters, I start with that initial so that all his parts will stay together. And then I can say backpack. And it's a graphic, not a movie clip. They both do pretty much the same things, but I like to sort them by what they are, and I would say they're graphics. So let's create that. And you'll see that over in the right side here, well, look what we have. The blue backpack shows up. It's there. Even if I delete the one that's on our stage, the one in the library is saved for good, and I can use it again and again and again. So let me lock that layer and go to the next one. Let's look at the legs. Now oftentimes, your legs, you'll want them as separate pieces for walking and things like that. For now though, I'm going to do these legs as one whole piece. And again, I'm going to go Modify, Convert to Symbol. Okay, so again, MB, we'll say legs, and then we'll say standing. Now you notice that also by clicking on the layer up here, that it selects the whole everything that's on that layer. So in my name, you'll see that I'm giving sorting it by category. So I know it's all part of Monkey Boy. I know that this is part of an arm because I may have 5, 10 different arms. I know which side of it his body it goes on, and then I know kind of the general gesture or positioning that it's in. So my naming scheme makes sense, and I'm staying organized. You'll see that down here in my library, everything is really easy to see, really easy to organize, and I don't have to search very hard for the pieces I need. So there we go. So you see now that when I select everything, they're all grouped, so you can zoom in. So each of these blue rectangles shows the boundary box of that symbol. Okay, so let's put the relaxed arm on top there. And And let's get the backpack in. Where's that? Change. Send to back. Let's get his tail. Actually, I'm going to put the tail. I'm going to delete that. Tail on a new layer. Call this one tail. Because I'm going to try to see if I can make the tail move a little bit. So here's the tail. And I'm going to use my free transform tool here. I'm not going to change the size, but I'm going to change this little white dot in the center. And I'm going to put it right down at the base of this tail. So that when I rotate it, you can see it rotates based off that point, and I can make it look like it's wagging around a little bit. Let's bring that down underneath. There we go. So that looks good.